the ring.
Did you watch Juan's fight? Juan is now 10-0.
I know.
Congratulations, Juan. How's it feel?
Bro, I got sick. I couldn't go.
You got sick? What did you have?
I had like a fever and everything. Like two days. I went to Vegas a week before the fight.
Yeah. Who keeps bringing it up? Is that you?
Lower that radio down.
Yeah, I did. So Ricky tells me you're a big director.
That's what they tell me.
You did the best movie. Wait, I was here the other day and I asked him what was the best movie ever.
Yeah.
And the guys in the gym, they said Training Day.
Oh, that's what's up. That's
you directed it?
Yeah.
That's insane.
I just got my Training Day just now.
Nah, you look like you look like you're ready to fight Anthony Joshua right
that's
now.
My Training Day right now, man. Sheep or wolf? I walked in here as a sheep. I'm still not a wolf yet, but I'm working on it, baby.
You know he's doing the remake of Equalizer 2?
I didn't know that. I know there's a fighter named Gervonta Davis.
Who's that?
Gervonta Davis. He's a world champion. Yeah, he's Floyd Mayweather's fighter. He's fighting in England May 20th.
Okay.
I was with him in New York before his last fight, and he was walking the streets of New York saying, King Kong ain't got nothing on me.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. And now one of his logos in every Instagram is a gorilla. They got it from the movie, of course.
You gotta pay your dues for that, then.
You gotta...
They gotta brand it.
For that. Hey, as long as they keep it going, I don't mind.
They're not doing it.
I love it, man.
So, why do you love boxing?
Discipline.
He did Southpaw, you know that, right? He directed Southpaw.
You directed Southpaw?
Yeah.
It's a great movie, too.
And these cats are like, you know, these are warriors, man. It's the most...
It's the only sport
left.
I'm going to be the guy that gets
pure.
Get shot. Come on,
as far as I'm concerned, it's pure. Two cats in the ring getting down, man. No excuses. Right?
Absolutely. What was it like working with a superstar like Denzel?
It's like working with Muhammad Ali. It's like training Muhammad Ali.
Right?
He's good to go. That's badass.
Do his thing.
But there were so many great scenes in the movie, from like when they wanted to kill him, when they find the wallet with the picture, and he saved my... Sometimes I find myself in similar situations where I'm playing cards with people, and they're like, this may not end that good.
Oh, yeah, you know what I mean? You ever get your pushed in?
Yeah.
That's real, man.
And those are real cats where you guys filmed that, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, man, they showed me some love, man. They let me jump through the neighborhood.
How about the jungle? How hard was it to get in the jungle?
Nah, they showed me love, man. Yeah. Everywhere I went, man. Latinos, blacks, clubs, Crips, everybody was cool. Like, come on through. Because, you know, it's important, man, the kids. The little kids get to see something different.
Yeah.
Man. So I was like, man, let's all be positive, put everybody to work. Everybody can eat.
Yeah.
They was like, let's do it. So it was cool. Not one problem. We had not one issue.
They know how to handle the business.
They used to be one of my main sponsors right here.
Really?
Yeah.
That would be sick.
I'm going to on my shorts there. It's my main sponsor right there.
What is it going to say? What's the company?
Antoine, baby.
All right, Brandon's not...
That's branding you as US bitch.
Hey, I'll be his bitch if he's going to pay me.
That's right. Get money. Get that money.
I'll be his bitch if he's going to pay me.
So, talk about who's your favorite fighter right now in the world active? Do you have any?
Just active?
Yeah, that you watch right now.
Watch my man right
here. Brandon Reels?
Brandon Reels, a beast.
Brandon's a natural, he's not like an actor. He can only probably do adult films at this point.
Low budget ones too.
And you'll be the
straight bootlegged.
Yeah.
No, not me.
Like the 1980s ones?
Canelo's a beast.
Canelo?
Triple G.
They're fighting now. Yeah. Canelo, who do you like?
You know what, man? I mean, whoever wants it. Whoever wants it.
To go fight.
I just want a good fight.
September 16th, and Brandon may fight on the undercard against Lucas Matisse, the Argentine. That would be good.
Hey, you owe me 1,000 push-ups.
I owe him 1,000 push-ups.
You owe him 1,000
push-ups? Yeah, because
Klitschko lost.
Klitschko almost had it. I think Klitschko let him off the hook. He let him off the hook.
Oh, what do you put it down? You got to finish him.
Why was he standing there?
You got to finish him.
He's old. He's old.
That's even...
He doesn't do it again, though, right? They're doing it again?
Possibly. I think so. It made a lot of money, 90,000 people.
They should. Yeah. Boxing needs it, man.
Props to Anthony Joshua for doing it.
He did. No, but he got to be honorable. Got to give the other man a shot again. He gave him a good fight.
But wait, Antoine, you did Southpaw, right? You directed it.
Yes.
Victor Ortiz was in Southpaw, right?
Yeah.
You know that Victor and Brandon have a 10-year, like, real beef, like, for real. Like, they hate it.
I know. I heard.
Now you know Brandon, you know Victor. Maybe you can help put the fight together.
Maybe. You never know.
Brandon, he directed Victor in Southpaw.
I know.
Oh, now he met you.
Bro.
Don't instigate shit, Eddie.
I'm not instigating. I'm making business deals.
Hey, they're two good men. They're two good men.
Great. Hey, you know what? That fool cacked out. We're supposed to fight, so I'm not talking about it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We're supposed to fight, and it never supposed to happen. You didn't want to fight, so. Yeah. That guy's talking about your head already. Yeah, I'm not.
Hey, Mayweather McGregor, you know what Dana White told me?
What?
That Canelo Triple G took their date.
Well, everybody's gonna want to see Canelo Triple G that McGregor.
Yeah. No one ain't gonna see Floyd and Craig McGregor that day.
Why not?
I would like to see Triple G and Canelo better. Yeah. Even though I like Floyd, that's my boy, but.
Honestly, like, who the fuck is McGregor?
He's an MMA fighter. You gotta
talk
about
that. Yeah, who the fuck is he in boxing, bro? No.
People are gonna see Triple G and Canelo. That's what they wanna see.
Yeah, that's a fight to shoot right there.
I just wanted to see McGregor get his ass kicked.
Ellie, Mario was there and he didn't touch it.
Oh, Mario. Mario Lopez.
I was looking for him.
He called out Mario Lopez. Mario Lopez.
I was looking for him.
Mario Lopez would take you to school, man.
He wouldn't take me nowhere. He was nowhere to be. Every time I came near him, he disappeared. So I don't know where he is.
Ellie, he'll take you to school. You would have been good on the undercard. Way under. Mario Lopez could box. Yeah, he could box.
Yeah, only if you don't hit him to the face of the body. Like, don't hit me. So a great boxer if you can't touch him.
Hey, Brandon.
Brandon, next time you fight, tell your opponent, don't hit me to the face of the body.
Is he wearing the nuts?
No, just don't hit him anywhere. Just let him hit you.
Usa la cintura, usa la cabeza, Brandon. There we go.
What's the next big movie that's coming out?
I'm going to do Equalizer 2.
Yeah.
So I'm filming in September.
That's huge.
Yeah.
That's badass.
I'm gonna get into it again, man. So, look for that.
How did you get started?
Oh, man. Went to college playing ball.
What were you? What, football?
Basketball.
Where?
West Virginia. Yeah, and then I moved from Pittsburgh to New York. Worked my way up, man, in PA and writing.
That's gonna be his first movie, Ellie, which I love.
What was your first movie?
The Replacement Killers, Childhood Fat, Mara Sorvino. That's my first one.
What was your first movie?
Replacement Killers.
The Replacement Killers, the Childhood
Fat.
A lot of shooting.
Yeah, I love shooting movies.
Yeah, a lot of shooting.
You love shooting in real life too. That's a joke, Ricky. I'm fucking around. I'm fucking with you. We're just joking, that's why.
He's on fire today.
No, but look, you're in a very, very not only competitive industry, but it's who you know. Not what you could be the best, but if you don't have the right connection, you're never gonna get that break.
That's right.
How did you get that first break? Who believed in you to say, okay, we'll let you do our project? Because you're doing projects that they're investing tens of millions.
Yeah, I mean, first you gotta put the work in, you know what I mean? But I did. I was a PA, I was trying to go get coffee, so did all that. Then I, you know, did music videos, did commercials. And work my way up. A lot of people like Academy of Steve Rollin, I probably had the films. A lot of cats, man. You know what I mean? It takes a lot of people to help me get there, you know what I mean?
But here, let me ask you if this is accurate sometimes. People love you when you're struggling.
Yeah.
But when you become very successful, the haters come out of the woodworks. Do you notice that? Or you're so successful, you don't notice them?
Oh, yeah, all day. Just take that fire and keep pushing.
You don't care.
Once you get there, you can't just be relaxed.
Look, Ricky got some haters. They what? Comment on his social media. Brandon got more haters than anybody.
I'm not here.
You got a lot of haters.
No, you got more haters too.
I don't have haters.
You know your name. Your nickname. You know your nickname is right. Your name is Ellie Setback, and they call you Ellie Suckballs.
Or they call Ellie Wetback.
Ellie Suckballs. Oh, really?
It's better than what Gordo used to say.
Hey, Antoine, Eddie's the one who put me out in the mat in boxing.
Oh, yeah?
He's the one, 8 years ago, he
what? Eddie sucked dick.
He started putting my name out there. It made me very popular.
Ricky's popular in his own right. He trains a lot of real big people.
You know how Ricky's popular? He did a video with, like, Kardashians.
Thank you.
Whatever it takes.
Whatever it takes. He did a video like the Kardashians.
But who's on your team in West Virginia? Did you have a... West Virginia, who played on your team?
West Virginia is first. I went to West Virginia State first to play ball. When I was playing ball, the guys I played against was like Saddell Creek, but Saddell was older than me.
He was a beast. He played for the Lakers, of course. The point guard. He was like a little baby... Nick Van Exel.
Yeah, Nick Van Exel, man. I was a youngster, though. But I stopped balling, man. I got to the arts.
I had a friend who played there, because I played at Valley College.
Yeah.
Now he works for the FBI or the CIA, one of the two. But it's both his parents are secret agents.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, he's like 6'6", very smart kid. From Simi Valley.
Yeah, man, yeah, it was a long time ago, bro.
But it's good, hey, you play ball. There are a lot of leagues in Hollywood.
You know,
you don't play it anymore?
Nah, man, I like getting in the boxing ring and working. Being with my family.
Yeah, Denzel boxes a lot.
Yeah.
He goes to the gym, La Brea over there.
Yeah. I go over there sometimes too. Terry, cool, man. Terry helped me out on Southpaw.
I thought it was a great movie.
Thanks.
I saw Shadid Saluki work in a corner and his son. Yeah. What do you say?
I hope he does another boxing movie.
And they could put you in it?
Never mind.
Antoine!
You don't read any movie, you don't sell for shit.
I don't know, Ricky's got the followers, man.
Huh?
Ricky's got the followers. I mean,
yeah.
Yeah, followers.
You know what I mean?
You know, you got followers, you did the Kardashian movie.
That's okay, that counts.
You see how good they got. They did something right.
You know who did the Kardashian with me? He sucked me up and I was like, yeah.